In this video, we're going to talk about the muscle spindle apparatus and the stretch reflex. And the muscle spindle actually provides for two separate purposes. One is that it gives us proprioceptive information about our bodies in space. In other words, it tells us about where, especially, our limbs are in space by detecting changes in muscle length. In addition, the stretch reflex, mediated by the muscle spindle, can help protect from inadvertent stretch of a muscle. So let's see how it works here. At the top left here, we have someone holding a glass that's being filled. And in the process, the load on the biceps muscle here is increasing, generating stretch. We look at the blown up version of the muscle. We have the muscle spindle in this sort of encapsulated structure, and it has intrafusal muscle fibers. They are contractile, but they're not contractile for the purpose of moving the limb, of moving the joint. We can get to that in just a moment. The extrafusal fibers of that muscle are the ones within motor units that allow for movement around that joint. Now, when stretch occurs, the intrafusal fibers are pulled on, and there are sensory nerve endings wrapped around those muscle fibers. And that generates an increase in action potential frequency that is sent into the central nervous system. There are potential collaterals that would travel upward through the spinal cord to make us aware of these changes in muscle length. But in addition, those afferent fibers will synapse directly with motor neurons, efferent neurons, that innervate those extrafusal fibers. So as muscle stretch occurs, we increase our firing frequency, we stimulate the alpha motor neurons to the extrafusal fibers and cause them to contract, essentially protecting that muscle from inadvertent stretch. And so we actually won't drop this glass of water as we add load to it here by adding water. Now, it's important to remember that in addition to that protection from inadvertent stretch, we're also gauging our changes in length so that we are aware of the position of our limbs in space. Now, for that to remain true throughout the range of motion, these intrafusal fibers, right, associated with the muscle spindle, have to also be contractile. Because when a muscle contracts, the extrafusal fibers contract, the muscle spindle would tend to get slack, reducing its sensitivity. And so we would also need the intrafusal fibers to contract to some degree just to maintain some degree of tension within this muscle spindle so that it can be sensitive to changes in length.